गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, आई एम डॉक्टर देशमुख अमोल जगन्नाथ, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ प्लांट पैथोलॉजी, कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, नवसारी एग्रीकल्चरल यूनिवर्सिटी, वघई, गुजरात. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर इन द कोर्स इंट्रोडक्टरी प्लांट नेमेटोलॉजी ऑफ सेकंड सेमिस्टर BSc ऑनर्स एग्रीकल्चर. द टॉपिक ऑफ द कोर्स इज सिम्टम्स कॉज्ड बाय प्लांट पैरासाइटिक नेमेटोड and nematode plant pathogen interactions. So let us discuss symptoms caused by plant parasitic nematodes. So what is symptom? Symptom is nothing but visible expression of a plant disease or plant parasitic nematode infestation. So these symptoms of the nematodes are classified into two category. One, symptoms produced by above ground feeding nematodes and symptoms produced by below ground feeding nematodes. As we know that there are two types of nematodes, one are foliar nematode and second are soil rhizosporic or root inhabitant nematodes, and that's why these are classified into these two categories. So let us start with the symptoms produced by above ground feeding nematodes. So there are different types of symptoms. These are produced by foliar nematodes on different foliar plant parts. The foliar plant parts may be seed, may be leaves, may be buds, may be stem, may be other such parts which are above ground. So first symptom is dead or devitized bud, second crinkled stem and foliage, third one is seed gall, fourth necrosis and discoloration of foliar plant part, fifth leaf lesions, sixth twisting of leaves and stem, seventh leaf discoloration, and such other symptoms may be produced by these above ground feeding nematodes. So let us discuss these with different photographs. So here you can see dead or devitized buds which are produced by strawberry foliar nematode, example Aphalancoides frageri. This nematode infestation kills growing buds in the strawberry. Next one is crinkling of the stem and foliage. So such types of symptoms are mainly observed in case of wheat by the infestation of wheat gall nematode Anguna titicus. So seed gall formation. So seeds are replaced by the galls. So here also wheat gall nematode, that is Anguna titicus, is responsible. The larva of Anguna titicus enter into the flower primordium and it will develop into the galls, and these galls are the galls which contains number of juvenile stages and male and female stages of these nematodes. Then necrosis and discoloration. These types of symptoms are produced by red ring nematode, that is Rhadenophalancus coccophyllus in case of coconut. And due to this infestation, red colored circular area appear in the trunk of infested palm of coconut tree. Then leaf lesion. Again, foliar nematode of Chrysanthemum, that is Aphalancoides rhizomybosi, is responsible for causing leaf lesions and leaf blighting in case of Chrysanthemum leaves. So these are the symptoms which are produced on broad leaf foliage plants. then twisting of leaves and stem. So here you can observe, in case of onion, the basal leaves become twisted when infested with Dytelenchus dipsaci. So these all are the above ground feeding nematode symptoms. So leaf discoloration. So rice tip nematode or paddy leaf tip nematode, that is Aplanchoides bc, is responsible for causing leaf discoloration or white tip in case of rice. So these all are the symptoms of above ground feeding nematodes. Let us discuss the symptoms produced by below ground feeding nematodes. So as we know, below ground feeding nematodes are feed basically on the root or rhizosphere of the different crop plants, and as the root system disturbs, the root are not uptaking water and nutrient, and translocation is not takes place, and due to that they may be produce above ground symptoms and as well as below ground symptoms. That is why the symptoms of below ground feeding nematodes are classified as above ground symptom and below ground symptom. So in case of above ground symptom, stunting, discoloration of foliage, wilting, decline and dieback, these are the major symptoms which are caused by different types of nematode. Say for example, Heterodera aveni, mole disease in wheat and barley causes stunting, Globodera rostochinensis, golden nematode in potato, also causes stunting, discoloration of foliage caused by root lesion nematode, Rattelenchus coffee in coffee plant, white tip nematode Aplanchoides bc in rice, citrus nematode Tylenoculus semipenetrans in citrus, wilting caused by root knot nematode in number of crop plants, and dieback caused by burrowing nematode in case of banana Rhodopolis similis. So we can see below ground symptom. So below ground feeding nematodes are responsible for different types of symptoms produced on root or rhizosphere. So first one is root galling, which is caused by Melodogyne, Nacobus, Dytelenchus, Hemicyclophora, Gypnema. Reduced root system caused by number of different nematodes we will see with photographs. Stubby root, so it is caused by Trichodorus christi in corn. Coarse root, it is caused by Balanolimus longicaudatus, that is sting nematode in case of corn. Curly root are produced by Gypnema, which is also called as fish hook type symptom, as one can use hook for fishing purpose, and that is why the roots are produced as like as hook of the fishing hook. That is why these curly root symptoms are also called as fish hook like symptoms. Then root lesions, necrotic lesions may be observed on the roots due to lesion nematode Pratelenchus species, Rhodopolis similis, burrowing nematode in case of citrus and banana, or Helicotylenchus multisynctans in banana. Then root rotting may be caused by nematode and microorganism in different crops, as say for example Dytelenchus destructor cause potato rot. Excessive root branching may be caused by some of the nematode, say for example Melodogyne hapla causes excessive root branching in tomato. So let us see the example with photographs. So first one is above ground symptoms caused by below ground feeding nematodes. First one is stunting. So as the nematodes are infesting to the root, the above ground foliage or stems get stunted. And you can see this is healthy plant and it is infested plant with Globodera rostochinensis, that is golden cyst nematode of potato. So here yield is also reduced. Or potato, you can see there are total number of potatoes are very less in case of infested potato plant than that of healthy plant. Then stunting caused by mole disease of wheat. So here you can see this is ray stunt variety and this is susceptible variety. In this case, Heterodera veni causes reduced plant growth. Then discoloration of foliage, citrus nematode causes discoloration of the foliage. Here you can see number of leaves or even fruits, they get discolored due to the semi endoparasitic nematode, that is Tylenculus semipenetrans in case of citrus. Then leaf discoloration, the leaf tip of rice become white or discolored due to rice white tip nematode, that is Aphalancoides basi. So it is also one of the very important symptoms which are caused by this below ground feeding nematode. Then we will see some of the symptoms which are produced on roots or below ground symptoms which are produced by below ground feeding nematodes. First one is wilting. So you can see here root knot nematodes are responsible for causing wilting in case of chili. Then decline and dieback, it is caused by burrowing nematode in case of banana. So decline was taking place, so dying up of branch from upper side to lower side occurs and the dieback occur. So root galling, so Melodogynous species are responsible for formation of root galls or root knot on the host root. In case of reduced root system, number of nematodes are feeding on the root and the tip of the growth is arrested, and which gives rise to reduced root system. So here you can see in all the figure the roots of these plants are get arrested by nematode infestation. Then root lesions, necrotic lesions mainly produced by root lesion nematode, that is Pratelenchus species, which affects number of crop plants. So here you can see lesions are produced due to infestation of this Pratelenchus species. Then production of coarse roots, so in case of corn or maize, sting nematode, that is Balanolimus longicaudatus, is responsible for causing coarse root. So lateral roots are stopped their growth with no branches occur, and due to that we have seen the coarse root system which gives rise to reduction in foliar development. So these all are the symptoms. Then coarse root, so lateral root stop their growth with no branches. So these types of symptoms are also produced by number of nematodes. Then stubby root, so here you can see at the end or at the tip the roots get stubby, or stubby branches or of rootlet occurred, or these are arranged in clusters. So it is caused by the nematode Trichodorus christi in maize or corn. So these all are the symptoms which are produced by above ground feeding nematodes and below ground feeding nematodes. So dear student, I want to state here you that you must have to keep in mind all the examples. Say for example, in your exam one may ask question about define nematode and enlist out the symptoms of nematode caused. So you can classify the symptoms in A and B, that is symptoms produced by above ground feeding nematodes and symptoms produced by below ground feeding nematodes. So for each and every symptoms you must have to quote the example of these nematodes so that it will be effective. Even in the exam, one may ask for objective, that is wheat gall nematode, or crinkled stem and foliage are caused due to dash dash nematode in wheat. So you can give the disease or nematode, that is wheat gall nematode, Angonia triticae is responsible for causing crinkled stem and foliage. So such types of examples or objective questions may be asked in your exam. So the examples of these nematode species which are infesting different crops and causing different types of symptoms are most important in our course, and that is why you must have to keep. And as I have given the different photographs, so you must have to go through it so that you can remember all the nematodes as well as their symptoms in detail. So now we will discuss about nematode plant pathogen interaction. So dear student, nematodes are responsible for infesting different types of crops. As we know, it causes 12.4% losses in case of crops, and it is also responsible for causing higher losses or higher monetary losses in Indian history. So when the study was taken place on nematode and plant pathogen interaction, it was found that the nematode infestation is responsible for secondary infection of the plant pathogens such as fungi, bacteria, viruses, etc. As these nematodes causes mechanical injury, and that injurious place favors the entry of microorganism, and at that place the association of these nematodes and pathogen takes place, and due to which the pathogen plant may suscept and cause the diseases. So nematode fungus interaction. Nematode fungus interaction was first observed by Atkinson in cotton in the year 1892. So the disease was Fusarium wilt, and the nematode was Melodobine species. So you must have to keep in mind as historical significance of this nematode fungus interaction. And since then, the nematode fungus interaction had received considerable attention on important crops like banana, cotton, cowpea, brinjal, tobacco, and tomato. Some example of this nematode fungus interaction are given in the following table. So you must have to keep in mind all the interaction so that it is very useful for your exam point of view as well as for competitive exam point of view. So in case of cotton, there are two diseases, damping off, the nematode which is responsible for favoring this disease in association with the fungus is Melodogyne incognita. The fungus are Rhizoctonia solani and Pythium dibarianum, and the role of this nematode is to assist the disease. In case of vascular wilt, again Melodogyne incognita as well as Rotulencus reniformis are important and assist to favor the vascular wilt, and the fungus is Fusarium oxysporum, if species vas infectum. So in case of tobacco, also damping of disease, nematodes melanogaster incognita, fungus, Pythium divinorum, as well as alternate retinues, which assist and favor the disease damping up. Then tobacco vascular wilt, melanogaster incognita, Fusarium oxysporum, as well as Fusarium parasitica, which assist to favor vascular wilt disease. In case of banana, vascular wilt or Panama wilt is favored by burrowing nematode, that is Rhodopolis similis, and the interaction is essential as it causes too much losses in case of banana if the nematode infestation is present. In case of tomato, cortical rot caused by Globodera rostrochinensis in assistance with Rhizoctonia solani. Tomato vascular wilt, Melanogaster species plus Fusarium oxysporum. Potato damping up, it is also caused by interaction between Ditylenchus destructor and Phytophthora infestans. Potato cortical rot, Globodera rostrochinensis, this is golden cyst nematode, and Rhizoctonia solani or Verticillium dahali, this is fungus. Then in case of onion, damping off is occurred due to the nematode Ditylenchus dipsacki and fungus Botrytis ali interaction. In case of brinjal, vascular wilt is occurred due to Pleasant nematode Pratylenchus penetrans and Verticillium dahali fungus. In case of wheat, stem rot is occurred due to the interaction between nematode Anguna triticae and fungus Dilophosphora allopecuri, and it is also a essential type of interaction. Then in case of wheat, again wheat rot caused by Heterodera aveni nematode and fungus, that is Rhizoctonia solani interaction. So these all are the nematode fungus interaction which gives rise to number of major diseases of these solanaceae as well as horticulture plant diseases. So the nematode fungus interaction is one of the very important, that is why you must have to keep in mind the history, that is Fusarium wilt plus Melanogaster species. It is first fungal nematode interaction which was given by or observed by Atkinson in 1892, and then you must have to keep in mind all the other examples so that you will definitely write in your exam. Then we will see nematode bacterium interaction. So as we know, there is one of the very important disease, it is Tundu disease, and it is actually asked in number of ICR-JRF, ICR-SRF, ICR-NET and ICR-ARS exam as a objective point of view, and you must have to keep in mind wheat Tundu disease is caused by the interaction between nematode Anguna triticae, that is seed coil nematode, and bacteria Clavibacter triticae, and it is one of the essential interaction. In case of tobacco, vascular wilt is caused by a nematode Melanogaster incognita and bacterial interaction, that is Pseudomonas solana serum. Then in case of tomato, vascular wilt is caused by either Melanogaster habla or Melanogaster incognita plus Pseudomonas solana serum interaction. Tomato canker is caused by Helicotylenchus nanus or Melanogaster incognita nematode with Pseudomonas solana serum and Clavibacter mycae genus bacterial interaction respectively. In case of potato, vascular wilt is caused by the interaction between root knot nematode and Pseudomonas solana serum bacterial interaction. So these all are the too much important nematode bacterial interaction you must have to keep in mind. So in your exam you can easily write. So here you must have to keep in mind the Tundu disease of wheat, which is caused by the interaction between Anguina tritici and Clavibacter tritici. It is one of the very very important question for objective type in case of ICAR JRF, ICAR SRF, NET and ARS exam. So you must have to keep in mind. Then nematode virus interaction. So nematode virus interaction was first identified by Hibbitt, Raske and Goin in 1958, and they have reported that the dagger nematode, that is Zipinema index, was responsible as a vector to transmit grapevine fan leaf virus. So this interaction you must have to keep in mind in number of ICAR JRF, ICAR SRF, NET and ARS exam. This question is have been asked and will be asked. And after the first virus nematode interaction, the studies was undertaken and it was found that the dagger nematode, Longidurus, Para Longidurus or Trichodurus, these types of nematodes are responsible for causing number of diseases. So these nematodes are mainly nepoviruses and native viruses. So Zipinema, Longidurus and Paralongidurus, these nematodes are responsible to transmit nepoviruses, while Trichodurus and Paratrichodurus, these types of nematodes are responsible for transmitting native viruses. So what is nepo? So nepo means nematode transmitted polyhedral septoparticle viruses. So you must have to keep in mind the long form of this nepo. So one may ask in your exam, then long form of NETU is nematode transmitted tubular shape virus particle. So this is all about objective type questions. So in your exam, the theory question on the short note of nematode virus interaction may be asked. So you have to give the historical significance of this nematode virus interaction, and you have to enlist some of the interaction. So in case of nepoviruses or polyhedral viruses, grapevine fan leaf and yellow mosaic virus is transmitted by Zipinema index. Tobacco ring spot virus transmitted by Zipinema americanum. Cowpea mosaic virus transmitted by Zipinema baseri. Tomato black ring or beet ring spot virus are transmitted by Longidurus elongatus. Tomato black ring or lettuce ring spot was transmitted by Longidurus attenuatus. So in case of native viruses, tobacco rattle virus or tobria virus are transmitted by Paratrichodurus species, that is Paratrichodurus aeleus, Paratrichodurus nanus, Paratrichodurus porosus, Paratrichodurus teres, or these may be transmitted by Trichodurus species. These are Trichodurus christi, Trichodurus primitivus, Trichodurus cylindricus and Trichodurus hooperi. P. early browning virus is transmitted by Paratrichodurus anemones, Paratrichodurus pachydermus, Paratrichodurus teres or Trichodurus viruliferus. So these all are the interaction of virus and nematode which are responsible for transmission of viruses. So you must have to keep in mind the nematode, how they transmit the diseases. So they acquire the viruses with the help of stylet, and after that some of the incubation period is required for replication of the viruses in virus body, and then after feeding on other plants, these types of nematodes are responsible for transmitting these viruses in other plants. So in case of grapevine fan leaf virus, it will exist up to 60 days in the body of Zipinema index, that is dagger nematode. So here you must have to keep in mind this point also. So these all are the examples of nematode virus interaction, nematode bacteria interaction, and nematode fungal interaction. So all these are very very important interaction you must have to keep in mind. So dear students, today we have seen the symptoms which are caused by different above ground feeding as well as below ground feeding nematodes on above plant parts or foliar plant parts and below plant parts, that is root system. So you must have to keep in mind all these symptoms as well as pathogen nematode interaction. And once again I want to state here that if you have any doubt, if you have any suggestion, or if you have any mistake found in this lecture, you must have to give a comment in comment back box so that I will incorporate this in next lecture. Thank you so much for attending the lecture.